friends, welcome back. In this video session, we are going to see how to set up a MySQL database in our project. Okay. In the past examples, I used in-memory database. Whenever I do database-related example, I used H2 in-memory database, right? That is problem with the database is whenever start the application, all existing data get vanished. Sorry, whenever shut down the application, the existing data from the database is vanished, right? Now I want to convert my in-memory database to H2 in-memory database to MySQL. Okay, let's see how to do that. After that, I will going to show some examples in JPA. I don't want to go deeply into JPA, but I will give the few examples, few topics in a JPA that will make you perfect in JPA side. You can handle your interviews, also you can work independently in your project. That much level I will cover in the JPA side. Okay, Now we're going to see how to convert our H2 in-memory configuration to MySQL. One more thing, now here I'm using application.properties. From now on I want to use the application.yaml file. The most of the project nowadays they're using the YAML file for their configuration. Okay, so I would like to change my configuration file to application.yaml file. Let's see, this is our existing project. I'm refactoring now. Sorry. I'm changing this name to old. Okay. Now I want to move this information to application YAML file. New file, application YAML file. This type of file generally used their project configurations only. Okay. I will copy here. The difference between application YAML file and application property file is, in the case of application property file, we'll go into repeating, right? So, under data source, we have a URL, driver, username, password. This many properties exist under data source property. For each and every time, if you want to use any property under data source and the spring, we need to type the entire thing. But in the case of YAML, not like that. Just you have to separate with colon, then enter under spring attribute. We have a data source attribute, then colon, enter under data source. We have a one property called URL. That property I need to assign your JDBC URL for MySQL. I have already ready make it that already available with me, that configuration. This is the JDBC URL. Okay, just pause that. Data source dot URL equal to this one, then data source, all these spring data source available, so you don't want to repeat this again, just remove it, keep it parallel to URL. So that meaning is, under data source we have a property called URL under driver class name. For the driver class name, I am using my MySQL driver. Then again, there is a username password under data source. So remove these two lines, these lines, make it under data source. Remove this also. Username is Suresh under Suresh123$. Now I don't want to use dialect here, it automatically takes dialect information. Then under spring JPA, see, under spring there is another attribute JPA, right? So I have to use this particular value here under JPA parallel to data source. That meaning under JPA we have a under spring we have another attribute called JPA. There is a another property called show SQL equal to true. Show SQL, I think we have to say like this, show SQL equal to true. See here, Yeah. Under JPA there is another attribute property called show SQL equal to not equal to colon true. Remove this. Okay. Now the spring we have a two property, data source, JPA. Under data source, whatever property coming, I mentioned here. Under JPA, I have another property called show SQL mentioned true. Then there is another property hibernate. Under hibernate, we have a one more property called DDL hyphen auto equal to update. That meaning it automatically create the tables. If you do any changes in the existing table, it automatically updates. For example, let's say there is a entity, right? There is one package called model per class. There is a product and a user. This is my MySQL workbench. This MySQL, let me connect. Okay, I'll going to connect local demo connection. It has a user, and user 123 is a password. See here. Edit connection. Username is a Suresh. Password is a Suresh 123 dollar dollar. I'm going inside that database. Here I mentioned Suresh 123 dollar dollar. I'm going inside the database. Database does not have any table, right? Any database. Now I'm going to create one database called building DB. That is whatever the DB I'm mentioning here. That building DB I'm mentioning here. Apply. 1 minute. I'll going to change. This is UTF-8. That is better. UTF-8. Then apply. Now I have a building DB. The building DB does not have any tables as of now. Since here I mentioned DDL hyphen auto equal to update, whatever attribute, whatever entity object available in the standard model package, in the product class I mapped with the one table called product. That product table should have following these columns. Like that user, I mapped with user table. That user table should have following column. Okay, I mentioned here, but this table does not exist here. Okay, so since I mentioned DDL hyphen auto equal to update, whenever start the application, your Spring Boot check this model attributes, that is entity object, and create a table equivalent to this attribute in our database. Okay, that is the purpose of this DDL hyphen auto. Then what else configuration pending? Then my server port. I want to server port is 8082. Sorry. This not required. This is not required. Server port will 8082. Then okay, I have given everything now. This is optional only. If you want, we can keep it logging level. Then dependency. This is very important. In the pym.xml file, as of now, I mentioned H2 in-memory database dependency, right? I don't want that now. I am removing this. I am adding MySQL artifact. So whenever Spring Boot see this artifact, automatically go and check this application.yaml, whatever database I mentioned here, it will go and connect and create this product and user table. Okay, this will happen by Spring Boot automatically by adding this artifact. Okay, by adding this MySQL artifact. Since we have already added Spring Boot started data if a JPA, by combination of these two artifacts, it will automatically connect whatever DB we have mentioned here. Okay. Let's see it's happening or not. Again, I'm going to check. Yes, everything looks perfect to me. Okay, I want to run the server 8082. Then Spring, under Spring we have a data source attribute. Under data source attribute, you have URL. Please make sure I'm giving a UCL, right? The application property, I given UCL here. UCL should not use. Okay, this is a problem. Not UCL, colon. We have to mention only colon. Colon one space. Okay, that's it. See, where from this property we are getting? What is the source of document? go to sorry. This is a Spring Boot data property. You can see here. There are the Spring document website. There are many properties they have given. Let's say I'm going to search this one. It's a Hibernate. See here, Spring JPA dot Hibernate DDL auto. I'm mentioning here Spring JPA DDL hyphen auto update. Spring JPA Hibernate DDL auto update. I'm using Spring JPA DDL auto update. I'm using here. Okay, like that, all properties are available here. Okay. See Spring data source. When you look at here, Spring data source, URL, driver class name, username, password. When you look at this document, Spring data source, username, password, where is that? Driver class name, then username, see username, then password. All properties are available here. You can learn a lot here by reading this documentation. Okay, see, all properties are taken from here only. Now I think the document, the configuration perfect for MySQL. Let's run now. See here, I don't have any table now. Okay. Since I mentioned DDL -auto, it automatically create the table name. So SQL will going to show the console whatever SQL statement executing by the Spring Boot app, that DML statement will appear here if the configuration everything perfect. Yeah, I got some error now. Unsatisfied exception. Data source. Spring DASURC data source. Cannot load driver class name com.mysql.cj.jdbc driver. Driver class name. Why it is? I added already MySQL connector. Let's see. We are going to update the Maven. Okay. It might be not updating Maven properly. Yeah, what I was thinking is correct, because I just added Maven artifact, right? I just added this artifact, but somehow my project not updating this artifact properly. That is the reason the error was coming. Now when you look at this console, Hibernate, create table, product, create table, user, these two tables created successfully. Okay. Two tables were created successfully. When you look at the database, refresh, see product table created, respective column, and user table created, respective column is available here. Okay, so now we converted our H2 in-memory database configuration to MySQL database. From the next class, we'll going to start JPA. But before that, I want to say one more thing, Swagger. I want to tell about the Swagger. Okay, what is Swagger? What is the use of Swagger in the Spring Boot RESTful app services? Okay, we'll see that. That is hardly, it will go 15 minutes. After that, we'll continue to work on JPA part. Okay, if you have any question, please comment out. Definitely, I will reply you. Okay, until the next video. Bye-bye from Suresh. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye-bye from Suresh K7.